Who's our next call?
We have someone on line one who disagrees with your advice to Hank.
Oh, really? Hello, you're on the line.
Congratulations, Frasier. You've done it again.
Why don't you ask her out to dinner, Dr. Crane?
You see, even though our marriage was unsuccessful, Lilith and I are quite capable of conducting ourselves as adults and even enjoying spending some time together from time to time. So, Lilith, 7 at my place?
Sounds great.
At our wedding, while Maris was reciting her vows, which she wrote herself, vows of love from the heart, I distinctly heard snickering. I glanced behind me, and there was Lilith, her fingers pressed hard against her lips, her body shaking like a paint mixer.
All right, now there she is. All right, now.
Go away.
Well, why does he listen to you and not to me?
By the tone of my voice, he senses I mean business.
Oh, I see. You're saying your voice is more commanding than mine is?
Hell, I took a half a step before I realized she was talking to the dog.
Martin, I'm especially delighted to see you here tonight.
Oh, yeah?
Oh, yes. Knowing as I do the history of your relationship with Frasier, when I heard that he'd taken you in, I immediately flipped to the Weather Channel to see if hell had indeed frozen over.
I hope you enjoy your convention.
For God's sake, Frasier, there is no convention. I'm here because of the letter.
The letter? What letter?
You know very well what letter. My darling, how could a love like ours have fallen so far from grace? There must be some part of your heart that still resounds to the rhythm of my own. I fear that I'll be lost without you. As long as we have love, love will keep us together.
Niles, I have a life here that suits me, and yet I can't help wondering if there is still some chance for reconciliation, if it's worth exploring the feelings that I'm feeling.
Frasier, before we go anywhere, I would just like to go on record as saying that, regardless of everything that's happened, I respect you for getting on with your life as successfully as you have.
Well, I'd like to say that I feel the same way about you. And Frederick is flourishing, and I'm sure that's in no small part due to you.
Oh, thank you. That means a great deal to me.
Geez, do you realize that's the first pleasant thing we've said to each other in almost a year?
You're right.
You know, I'm suddenly quite moved.
I am too.
Would it be a dreadful contretemps if I kissed you right now?
You can always try.
You want a bag dinner?
There's a bed and an honor bar. What more do we need?
Come to me, my white hot flame.
I was insane to divorce you.
Oh, God, you're in my thoughts every waking hour.
You're the only man I've ever loved.
So are you. I'll get that. Must be the breakfast we ordered last night. Boy, I am famished.
You should be. You were a busy boy. This is a mistake.
Oh, thank God you said that. Oh, it's not that last night wasn't very enjoyable, but who are we kidding? You've gotten on with your life, I've gotten on with mine, I've got a new career, I've reestablished relationships with my family, I've got a whole new set of friends. For the first time in years, I'm happy. I mean, for us to even consider getting back together, it's just the stupidest thing two people could do.
I meant the eggs. I ordered poached, not fried.
I'm not mad at you. I'm mad at me. I don't even know what I'm doing here. I've just been so lonely over the last year. When I found your letter, it was like a life preserver. I'm raising a child alone. I'm scared. I always thought of myself as a strong and independent person, but the truth is I'm afraid. I guess that's why I convinced myself that I was still in love with you.
You mean you're not?
No. Not.
Can't help telling you this. Even though we're not in love anymore, you were always the most exciting lover I ever had. I think in your heart of hearts, you'd say the same about me.
They screwed up the toast, too. I ordered rye.
Lilith.